not create me to worry. You did not create me to fear, but you created me to worship daily. So I'ma leave it all right here. Help me say yeah.
You did not create me to worry.
You did not create.
You did not create me to fear.
But you created
but
me.
You created me to worship.
Oh yeah.
Daily.
So I.
You did not create me to worry.
Reverend N.C. Sargent, the pastor of the Faith of Missionary Baptist Church.
And I'm Sister Toy Sargent, First Lady.
We'd like to take a moment to invite you to come and share with us on Sundays. Come and know that we're the church where every member is encouraged, excited, they are equipped, and expected to help reach the lost for Jesus Christ. Our address is at the bottom of the screen, phone number. Come and be a part of morning worship.
We love to see you there. This is Men's Day. We're going to rejoice in the Lord. The men's going to stand up today. They're going to do what God asked us to do. We're going to have a good time in the Lord today. We want y'all to back us up. Back us up. Because we're going to do our thing today. It's all going to be in the name of Jesus. Thank y'all for coming out today. I know more is coming. I want God to bless the one that's coming. We're going to have a good time today in the Lord. So help us. Y'all, we need y'all help.
Good morning, faithful, and our friends and visitors. This morning, we're going to ask y'all to help us out on this song we're going to try to do, all right? So we just need a little help. We're going to start off with, it's another day's journey. Lord, I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Hey, I'm glad about it. It's another day's journey. Lord, I'm glad about it. You know that I'm so glad to be here. Yeah, yeah. He woke me up this morning. Lord, I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Yeah, I'm glad about it. He woke me up this morning. Lord, I'm glad about it. You know that I'm so glad to be here. Yeah, yeah. He gave us food to eat. Lord, I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Lord, I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Yeah, I'm glad about it. He gave us help and strength. Lord, I'm glad about it. You know that I'm so glad to be here. Hey, oh, it's another day's journey. Lord, I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. Yeah, I'm glad about it. It's another day's journey. Lord, I'm glad about it. You know that I'm so glad to be here.
Good morning. I will read in Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all he land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know he that the Lord is God, and it is he that has made us. All and we. And not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gate with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good and mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generation. May the Lord have a blessing on his word of his door. Amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. Let's raise our voices and praise the Lord. You got a voice to raise, let's raise it. God is good. Is he good? You know, like my grandma used to say, oh, taste and see. And you know what she would tell me? She said, be quiet and breathe. Everybody breathe. Breathe in. You taste the Lord just then. He allowed you to breathe today. Taste and see, all right? Father God, we come just now to say thank you. Thank you for another day, another opportunity, and another chance to lift our voice and praise your holy name. Thank you for allowing us to be in your house one more time, Father God. Thank you for allowing us to walk in on all 2 feet, Father God. For those that don't have feet, Father God, pray for them, Father God. And Father God, thank you for our new pastor. Touch him right now, Father God. Guide him, Father God. Lead him, Father God, as you would have him to go, Father God. Touch our new first lady, Father God. Guide her, Lord. Give her the strength to stand behind him, Father God, and help him with all his troubles, Father God. Father God, on a special note, thank you for our past pastor, Pastor N.C. Sergeant, Father God, and our past first lady, Sister Toy Sergeant, Father God. Continue to lead him, Father God. Continue to bless him as only you can do, Father God. And Father God, bless the sick and shut in wherever they may be. Touch him right now, Father God. Go into their hospital rooms. Go into their homes, Father God. Touch him and give him the victory as only you can do, Father God. For victory is in you, Father God. And Father God, I thank you for the Jesus, Father God, my big brother, our Lord and Savior, and your son. For he died for our sins, Father God, for he was sinless. He bore our burden, carried our iniquities, and never said a murmuring word. Thank you for the blood he shed, Father God, for there's power in the blood of Jesus, Father God. There's healing in the power of blood of Jesus, Father God. There's deliverance and salvation in the power of the blood of Jesus, Father God. And we thank you for him, Father God. Bless each and every one of his members today, Father God. Touch him right now, Father God, and get him the victory as only you can do, Father God. Whatever they may need, Father God, I know their needs are already met through you, Father God. And Father God, we thank you for the victory. We thank you for the answer. We thank you for hearing our prayers and granting our requests. For it's in the mighty name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen and amen.
That ends our devotion. We just getting started. Can you feel it? Yeah.
Amen. They said I'm gonna be the MC today. I'm gonna negotiate my contract, but this is what I need. I need all the men out in the front, and we're gonna march in. Since they put me in charge, I need all the men in the front of the foyer. I don't know. I said all men. Okay.
Hello. I'm Reverend NC.
Come on, men. It's our day now. You got to move a little faster. You know, they already talking about us. We're gonna march in, and then we're going to do the praise and worship. The choir, men's choir, going to do the praise and worship. And then after that, we're going to do the altar prayer. Y'all got that? All right. Y'all ready? All right. We show, y'all. We can parse too, can't we? And clap your hands with us right there. Come on.
Test, test.
Fellas, y'all ready?
Yeah.
Fellas, y'all ready?
Yeah.
Fellas, I can't hear y'all. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
There we go. I think we're ready now. Come on. Hey, come on. Say,
say it, I feel like,
yeah.
I feel like having church.
That's all we got to say today.
Say it, I feel.
Yeah.
I feel like having church.
Y'all can help us say that on this morning.
Said I feel like,
oh yeah,
I feel like having church.
Church. Fellas, help me say it.
Said I feel like,
yeah,
I feel like having church.
Come on, that's all we say.
Said I feel. I feel like having church.
Come on, put your hands together.
I feel like,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
I feel like having church.
Come on,
I feel like having church.
Yeah.
I feel like having church. I feel like having church.
Yeah.
I feel like having church.
Yeah.
I feel like having church. I feel like having church.
Ooh.
Here we go.
I feel like having church.
The sun to the going down of the same, God is worthy. You know he's worthy. He is so worthy to be praised. Because this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, good morning, good morning. God bless you all. This is the day, and we come to praise him. We come to worship him, to give him all the glory, and to give him all the praise. This is a beautiful day this morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is what the psalmist say in Psalm 18. This is the day that the Lord has made. We can call it Men's Day. We can call it Women's Day. We can call it Children's Day. We can call it Great American, African American Day. We can call it Sunday. But this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. And we will glorify him. We will praise him because he is holy. He is our Lord God Almighty. And we worship him. We thank you, Lord. Under the leadership of our pastor, Pastor Byron Hanspard Sr. and Lady-elect Sister Yolanda Hanspard. And giving respect and honor to our bishop, Bishop N.C. Sargent and First Lady Tor Sargent. We love you all, and we thank you. We thank God, Father Pastor. We thank God for each and every one of you here in your prospective positions. And we praise you, and we thank God for you. Now we will have a prayer by Sister Hawkins. Thank you.
As she said, we will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. She said, yes, it is annual Men's Day, but this is the Lord's Day. Now, I am not a man, but I am a woman, and I know how to pray for men. And I am going to pray for the faithful men, but not only the faithful men. And I'm not going to stand by myself and pray. So come on, church. We're going to get up and we're going to pray. And we're going to present our supplications to the Lord. We're going to give thanks, for the Lord is good and he is greatly to be praised. We just thank him today. And we're going to celebrate Men's Day. We're going to celebrate African American Month. So we have so much to be thankful for. And there is power in prayer. So will you stand with me? We're going to stand on one accord, one heart, and we're going to lift up our voice, and we're going to give God thanks today. This morning, God, we just thank you. We thank you, God, for who you are, God. We thank you, God, for being a healer, Lord. We thank you, God, for being a provider, Lord. We thank you, God, for being a sustainer, Lord. We thank you, God, for being a deliverer, God. We thank you, God, for saving our souls today, God. We thank you, God, for freeing us, God. We just thank you this morning, God. And it's not about us, Lord, for it's all about you, God. For we're coming in this morning, God, recognizing, God, that you have all power, God. And we're just going to honor you today, God. We're just going to glorify you today. Lord, welcoming you into Faithful Missionary Baptist Church this morning, God. We're going to stand for prayer, God, knowing, Father God, that you're able, God, to do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ever ask or think, God. And we just thank you this morning, God. God, you can come in, God. You're welcome to come in and have your way, God. It's your service, God. Do what you want to do, Father God. We're asking, God, that you lift up these bowed down heads, Father God. Lord, we're standing, God. We're standing, God, for holiness, God. We're calling sinners to repentance, Lord. We're calling the backsliders, God, to come back unto the fold, God. God, we're asking strength for the family, equipping the saints, God. And Lord, we're doing it without compromise, God. So we thank you this morning, God. Lord, we're asking prayer, God. We're asking that you comfort, that you strengthen the bereaved family, God. We're asking a special prayer, God, for the white family, God. Lord, you know all about it, Father God. But we just thank you this morning for the life that was lived, God. Asking that you strengthen those hearts, Father God. Mend the family together, God. Lord, we thank you this morning, God. Asking that you go in the hospital this morning, God. We thank you, God, for the mother of this church, God, that you're continuing to strengthen her body, Lord. Mother Flowers, God, we're asking a special prayer, God, that you continue to stay with her, God. And Lord, as she said, you're an on-time God, and you never fail, God. And Lord, we just thank you this morning, God. We thank you, God, for every church that's open in your name, God, that is continuing to preach your uncompromising word, Father God, standing, God, for righteousness and holiness, God. Lord, you said it's good for brethren to dwell together, God, and to be at peace, God. So we're asking, God, that you forgive us, God, for all unrighteousness, God. Anything that you find in us that is not like you, Father, we're asking, God, that you remove it now, God, so that we may walk worthy of the calling, God, that you have set before us, Father, God, that when they look at us, God, they don't see us, God, but they see you, Father, God, that we demonstrate forgiveness, that we show love, God, compassion and mercy, God, for you are God, and you are love, God, and you've shown us love, God, for you came, God, and you died for us when we were unworthy, we were unfit, Father, we were filthy rags, God, but you came, Lord, you looked upon us, God, and you saw the need, you reached out, Father, God, and you saved us, Lord, from a devil's hell, God, in spite of the faults, in spite of the failures, in spite of the shortcomings, God, you shed love on us, God, and we thank you, God, Lord, you shed your blood, God, and I'm believing today in the power of the blood. Hey, the blood still works, God, and it's redeeming, Lord, it's delivering, God, it's healing, God, and Lord, I thank you this morning, God, I thank you, God, for the men of faith, for God, God, for those that standing for righteousness, God. You're calling spiritual leaders, God. You're calling the men to stand forth, God. Lord, you called them, God. You said, Adam, where art thou, God? You didn't look for Eve, but you said, Adam, where art thou? And Lord, we thank you, God, that these men are standing firm. They're standing strong, God. Continue to bless them. Continue to crown them with wisdom, God, and knowledge, God, that they can continue to stand for you, God, in an evil day, God, that they continue to stand firm, God.
We just Listen.
keeping. Now we do welcome and announcement. I'm reading the program. Well, we're going to do this part. We're going to do the welcome first. Billy, you ready? All right. They say I'm the MC, so I'm going to run this thing. Hello. All right.
All right, Mr. MC. Give it unto God, to Reverend Sergeant, Reverend Hanspard, to all the sisters and the brothers and to all the God's children, to the deacons. We welcome you to the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church on this fourth Sunday for our Men's Day. We hope you came to enjoy, not spectate, but enjoy the presence of the Lord, because we came here for no other reason but to lift up, magnify, and praise the Lord. For those of you who do not know, yes, we do have a new pastor. Yes, we are still having church. So what we've done in the past, we're still doing in the future. We're believing and we're trusting in God. So you are welcome to bless, to praise, to magnify the Lord with us. You are welcome.
Good morning, Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. I pray you all have had a fantastic week, and God continues to pour showers of blessings upon you. Here are your morning announcements.
You would like to pay your tithes, offering, donations, and love gifts to the church? You can do that now by Giveify.com. Search for Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. You should see our logo, select it, and start your giving. You can also download the app to always be with you on your mobile devices. And lastly, you can always scan the QR code that will be placed on the screen during giving. We thank you in advance for all of your giving.
Don't forget, if you have a baby that needs to be dedicated back to the Lord, we are now accepting participants. Please see Sister Kathy Taylor or Sister Tashana Young.
Oh yeah, don't forget, on every second and fourth Sunday of the month, we will be having our children's church doing our morning worship. See you there.
All current choir members and future choir members, please note that rehearsal has moved from Wednesdays to Tuesday nights. So join us to be a part of our growing and set on fire music ministry every Tuesday at 7 p.m. We look forward to seeing you there.
We will have prayer every Saturday at 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Come and pray with our pastor. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men are always to pray and not to faint. Luke 18:1. You can come pray and leave as you desire. This is a time to tarry, or just come pray in the house and leave after you've heard from God. All are welcome.
Bible studies will continue on every Wednesday for the rest of the month, studying the Book of James with our Pastor Byron Sr. The 2024 Travis Lee Young Scholarship application is now available. Starting February 25th, 2024, the application deadline is April 28th, 2024. All eligible candidates and high school seniors are encouraged to apply. For more information, please see Sister Kathy Conright or Sister Tashana Young. Faithful, stop and listen closely. Pull out your calendars and let's save the date. Sunday afternoon, March 17th, 2024, at 3 p.m., we will be having our installation service for our new pastor, Byron C. Hanspard Sr. We want to show up and show out, representing the Lord, our church, and pastor. More details to come soon, but save the date, and let's get ready to celebrate with our pastor.
All right, faithful, you know what time it is. If it's your birthday, you know what to do. At the count of three, let me hear you scream. 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday! All right now, faithful, if you're here and you're celebrating your anniversary, we want to celebrate you. So on the count of three, we're going to shout it out. 1, 2, 3. Here at Faithful, we love to praise God, and we love to love on God's people. So we welcome all guests, friends, and family. At this time, we want to just tell you welcome. So on the count of three, I'm asking the entire Faithful family, let's shout it to them, let's smile at them, and if they're next to you, why don't you give them a hug? One, two, three, welcome to Faithful! And now, ushers will pass out connect cards so that we may stay connected with you. All right. Now this concludes.
We already had our welcome, but we still want our guests that are here to stand on your feet. If we have any guests in the building, stand to your feet. We just want to see you real quick. All our guests, we want to see you real quick. Faithful, we got a lot of guests here. We want to show them some love. We just want to love on you and hug on you and let you know that we thank you for coming and joining us on today. Come on, Faithful, y'all know what to do. Let's tell them. Let's do this real quick. Faithful. Alright, we're going to move right along. But I just want to make one little extra announcement. We had the men's breakfast yesterday, and y'all missed it. Oh, y'all missed it. I'm telling you, Deacon Wesley threw down. Yeah, and we had 20 brothers there. 20! Alright, 20! Yeah. It was nice. I just want to put that in there. And we finna move right along to the, we finna get a reading by Early, not me, Early Miller, Black History, just in case. There you come. Where he's, there he is. All right. You need my mic? Okay, you got one.
No, I got one.
Okay.
Good morning, church. Good morning. Let's bow for a word of prayer right quick. Our Father, I thank you for allowing me to come before your people this morning to talk on Black history this morning. I'll be talking about Mason Temple Church in Memphis, Tennessee. First, I'm going to talk about how the church began. Matron Temple Church of God in Christ, named after the founder of Church of God in Christ, Bishop Charles Harry Mason. It first conceived in 1938. For the first 3 weeks of the church existence, service was held in the living room and on the front porch of our missionary mother, Martha Mayer. The service was later moved to the sidewalk in front of her house. The members stood at Rent Building on the 9th Avenue in Conway, South Carolina for $3 per month from Mr. Mrs. Hawkins. There were difficult encounters as the memo tried to get the church started. Overseer Jane from Florida came to Midway to help. He rented hall direct on the site next door to 1520 Race Pack, located owned by Masonic Lord from Mr. William Link. This arrangement later lasted for 2 years. Overseer James began the construction of the sanctuary on land purchased from the Masonic Lord. Builders had to leave prior to the completion of the building. Soon after, Mr. Charles Bennett did some work on the building. Mason, Deason Jimmy Johnson, and his wife, Mother Roberta Johnson, washed and ironed clothes to both raise money for the completion of the building and pay off the loan for the land. Now I'm gonna talk about the church. Mason Temple, located in Memphis, Tennessee, is a Christian international sanctuary and a center headquarters of the Church of God in Christ, the largest African American Pentecostal group in the world. The building was named for Bishop Charles Harrison Mason, founder of the Church of God in Christ, who is engraved in a marble crystal inside the temple. Mabel Temple was the site of Martin Luther King Jr. 1968. I've been to the mountaintop speech the night before his assassination. History. Mason Temple was founded by Charles Harry Mason, 1864 to 1961. This church domination, Church of God in Christ, also known as Church of God in Christ, grew fast in Memphis, Tennessee, and evidence spread to other parts of the world, such as Latin America and Asia. Mason Temple was the largest church building owned by a predominant black Christian domination, and in the United States, it is open. Charles H. Mason, born in 1864, a former slave, Mason was the founder of the largest Pentecostal cross denomination in the U.S., which had more than 7.5 million members. Mason obtained a preaching license from Mount Gayer Missionary Baptist Church in Little Rock, Arkansas. He was then cast out for preaching holiness and sanctification. With the help of an exiling member, Mason established the Church of God in Christ. It consists of 110 churches spread across Mississippi, Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Texas. Around that time, Mason attended the Sultric Revival, where he taught that he would receive the act of speaking in tongues once baptized in the Holy Spirit. On that night, he spoke in tongues. After he returned, he found himself in a disagreement about the turning of the Holy Spirit, which led to another split in the church. He took 10 churches with him and kept the church in God in Christ. Mason spent his year teaching in Arkansas. He came to Memphis in 1907. Attend the first meeting of the Pentecostal General Assembly of the Church of God in Christ. All right. By 1997, the denomination grew to 5.7 million. Civil rights. In the 1950s and 60s, Mavis Temple became a critical destination for minimal civil rights event in Memphis. Martin Luther King Jr., and Andrew Young, and Ralph Albert was among many black leaders who came to Memphis to assist and the 1,300 protesting sanitation workers who usually met at the church. Together they fought for better working conditions for black sanitation workers, as they earned lower wages and were treated different from white workers. Martin Luther King Jr. later delivered his famous speech, "I've been to the mountaintop," on April 3rd, 1968. The next day, Martin Luther King was assassinated out of his room at the Lorraine Motel. A plaque on the interior wall near the entrance of the church detailed the event. Before I sit down, I want to thank some of my family members for attending this morning, my two daughters, my niece, and all my family. And if I miss anyone, I want to welcome all of y'all. Thank you. And I hope y'all enjoy the service.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Do we have any praisers in the house? Do we have anybody that truly loves Jesus with all your heart, mind, body, and soul? Tell somebody, I love Jesus. That was the wrong somebody. Tell somebody else, I love Jesus because he first loved me. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is truly awesome. He is truly amazing. He truly has done great things for you and for me. Amen. So nobody should mind giving God glory, honor, and praise. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. Everything that hath breath, praise ye the Lord, because the Lord is good and he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. God is worthy. He's worthy to be praised. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God for those of you that are here. Amen. Our guests, our visitors, we praise God for you being here today. Amen. It's good to see your lovely faces on this men's annual day. Amen. Don't our men look phenomenal? Amen. Men in the audience looking great. Amen. Hallelujah. Where there are men are, there is strength and there is power. Amen. And I thank God that we have some powerful men of God here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. Amen. Amen. I have one more Black History fact that's going to come forth before I come forth. Jade Kaysen, where are you? Amen. Jade Kaysen is coming now. She has a Black History fact that she's coming forth with. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hello and good morning. My name is Jade Kaysen, and today I will be reading excerpts of The Hill We Climb, an inaugural poem for the country by Amanda Gorman. When the day comes and we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, the sea we wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. And the norms and notion of what just is isn't always justice. And yet the dawn is ours. Before we knew it, somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, simply unfinished. We the successors of a country in a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves, raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean that we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We're striving to form a union with purpose. To compose a country committed to all colors, cultures, characters, and conditions of man. So we lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our futures first, we must put our differences aside. We lay down our arms to reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none, harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. Even if we grieved, we grew. Even if we hurt, we hoped. Even if we're tired, we tried. Then victory won't lie in blade because all the bridges we have made. We've seen a force that would rather shatter our nation rather than share it. Would destroy a country if it meant delaying democracy? And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith we trust. For while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. We do not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. But one thing's for certain, if we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than what we were left with. Every breath from my Brown's pounded chest, we will raise the wounded world into a wondrous one. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful. When the day comes and we step out of the shade, aflamed and unafraid, the new dawn blooms as we free it. For there is always light, only if we're brave enough to see it. Only if we're brave enough to be it.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you to Deacon Early Miller. Amen. And we want to say thank you to Sister Jade Kaysen, amen, for representing Black History Month, amen. Praise the Lord. Jesus said, he asked, when he came to Caesarea Philippi, he said, who do men say that I am? The disciples said, some say you are Elias, Jeremiah's. Some say that you are John the Baptist. But Jesus asked the disciples, whom do you say that I am? Simon Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus said, because of that revelation that you received from my Father, upon this rock, upon this revelation, will I build my church. And this is the key, and the very gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Once you receive a revelation of the Lord and who he truly is, can't no devil in hell stop you. Can't no devil in hell block you. Can't no devil in hell overcome you, because greater is he that is within you than he that is in the world. So understand who God truly is. All right, that's y'all calling. I had to set it up because In December, January, as I was praying, as we were transitioning from Bishop, just stepping aside, and I'm just passing the baton to me, the Lord put something in my spirit. I believe here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church, not only do we celebrate Black history in February, but I believe that we have some phenomenal patriarchs here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church that has set the way, that has paved the way, amen, that understand that upon this rock I should build my church. And the great thing that I love about those that are going to be honored today, and I'm going to say this, the Lord put these 9 people in my spirit to be honored today, because I just believe that so many people have paved the way here for the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. So if we can honor other Black history representatives that have done great and phenomenal things, why we can't honor our people here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church that have done phenomenal works of the Lord here for creating and developing Faithful Missionary Baptist Church, amen. So let me say this, please let me say this. I'm gonna say this. This is not the last time that there will be honors presented to people. These are just the 9 that the Lord has put in my spirit for this time. We have church anniversary in April, gonna be more that are gonna be presented, amen, with a Black History honor, amen. We're gonna have more on Father's Day and on Mother's Day that are gonna be presented with an honor because they have done phenomenal and great things. So just because these 9 are being presented today, don't think I'm missing anybody, amen. I can't do 35, 40 all at one time, amen. So amen, so I just wanna let that be known, that I have 9 that the Lord put in my spirit for this time, but I will be presenting again, amen, in April for church anniversary, for Father's Day, and for Mother's Day as well. So don't think because your loved one or you have not been called today that that's it, amen. We have a wall of honor that's being placed outside on the wall, amen. Thank God for Sister Day, Deacon Day, amen, and their entire team. They're doing a phenomenal job of placing scriptures all over the church, amen. So we thank God for them, and we have a wall of honor that as soon as you walk out to the front to your right, that's being created, amen, for everyone that's going to be honored today and even in the future. Because I believe there are some that are deceased at this moment that would be honored, but I believe to honor those while they're here, amen, while they're alive, where they can enjoy your claps and they can enjoy your applause and they can enjoy your love, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Marcus, you in charge.
Mother Flora May Flowers.
Amen. Representative for
Mother Flora May Flowers, a jewel that landed at Faithful in 1985 and years later was asked to become the Mother of Faithful. Like a mother, she nurtures Faithful with wisdom and is always reminding us that God is an on-time God. He may not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time. She is the Mother of Faithful and shines as beautiful as her name, Flower. Give it up for Mother Flora Mae Flowers.
Amen. The certificate it reads Faithful Black History Legends Award. On the behalf of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church, I am delighted to congratulate Mother Flora May Flowers. And it reads, take pride in knowing that you are an inspiration to the Black community and to the people of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. I believe that it takes many hands to build strong ministry and soul safe communities, and you are a vital part of that important process. I commend you for your dedication to helping members of the church and community realize their full potential. 1 Corinthians 15 and 58 says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. On the behalf of Mother Flowers, we have Sister Edmondson, that's coming and representing her. Amen. Look, Mother Flowers, we love you. I know she's watching. Amen. We love you, Mother Flowers. Thank you, Sister Edmondson.
Minister Ruth Halton. Minister Ruth Halton, a servant of God, strong in her faith, will not compromise. She has been a faithful member for over 40 years, serving as a deaconess, Sunday school teacher, youth director, counselor, intercessor, women's ministry, and mother of Zion. She has touched countless lives in so many ways to a shoulder to cry on without passing judgment on you. But don't get it confused. She is going to tell you what thus said the Lord. But she will always, always hold your hand and tell you God loves you. She's truly a virtuous woman of God who loves her family, her church family, but most of all, she loves God. Give it up for Minister Ruth Halton.
been in this church as long as Pastor had, 47 years. 44, 47. I taught Sunday school. I taught for 40 years almost, 35. I taught Sunday school. I taught the teenagers. All them years. And I taught them what was right. I didn't compromise. And they came back later and told me how much they appreciate me. God is good. God is good. And I just want to say thank you all. Thank you all, you beautiful people. Beautiful people of the Lord. My son is here, Ronnie. Ronnie Holden is here. And I thank you, Lord, for Reverend Hanspard. You'll make it to the pastor. You'll make a good pastor. Thank you all.
Amen. Thank God for Sister Minister Evangelist, amen, Halton, amen. God bless you, we love you, amen. I know she's shocked, amen.
Daisy McGinty served as a loyal member of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church since when the church was founded. It all started in her parents' home. Mother McGinty is deeply committed to the work of the Lord and has a servant's heart. She's a humble woman of God and will assure you that if you only believe, all things are possible through Christ. She currently serves on the Nurses Guild to cater to those with health needs. She makes it her priority to reach out to all that comes to Faithful Missionary Baptist Church and greet them with love. She continues to be a soldier in God's army and bring healing to the body of Christ. She can often be seen after church giving out fresh veggies and food to help others.
Giving honor to God and to all the faithful. I'm so thankful to still be here and be alive in a portion of my health and strength in my mind. And I would love to say to faithful, continue on the work that we have started. God is with us. He'll be with us always, now and forever. Continue the work that God has placed in each of us to do what he said, do his will. Nobody else will. God, I thank you, I praise you, and I magnify his name.
Amen. Mother McGinty, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Daisy McGinty. Deacon Travis Lee Young. Deacon Travis Lee Young of Sulphur Springs, Hopkins County, Texas, later relocated to Dallas, Texas, and united with True Fellowship Baptist Church under the ministry of Reverend Sammy Davis Jr. He later united with Faithful Missionary Baptist Church under the ministry of Reverend N.C. Sargent. He was the chairman of the deacon board and superintendent of Sunday school. He was an employee of Kraft Foods in Garland, Texas for over 30 years and retired December 1995. Although Deacon Travis Young is no longer physically here with us, His legacy continues to live on as countless of donations has been given away to numerous high school graduates as college scholarships.
Been almost 30 years since my grandfather left this earth, and it was abrupt, quick, but and it still hurts. It still hurts. I'm 52 years old and still have a difficult time with it. But the one thing that makes it easy is to know that where he is for this almost past 30 years is with our Father in heaven. He lived every single day of my life for Christ. Every single day. And I stayed with my grandparents when, you know, I would get out of school. And so I know that the life he lived was for God. I know it because I saw him every single day. And I thank you for continuing his legacy because he was a beautiful man. He was a beautiful man. And I thank you, Pastor Sergeant, Sister Sergeant, because you poured into his life.
Amen. Thank you so much. Praise the Lord.
Deacon Early Miller. Deacon Early Miller, a faithful legend who proudly served in the United States Army from 1964 to 1966, where he was an aircraft mechanic. During this time, he was also trained as a sharpshooter. His love for working on airplanes greatly grew after his time with the Army, and he later found employment at Dallas Air Motive, where he would spend the next 43 years of his life until he retired in 2007. He married his high school sweetheart in July 1966, and from this union, 5 children were born. Although he is retired and no longer working on airplanes, you can catch him under a car hood when the need arises. And proudly serving as a deacon and Sunday school superintendent at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. He is not only a legend at Faithful, but one in his community and family. Give it up for Deacon Early Miller.
Thank everybody for thinking of me as that. And I want to give a kind to Pastor Sergeant. He encouraged me a whole lot to do different things. And I owe a lot of credit to him. And I just want to thank him for everything he did for me and for me.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Elder James Heskell. Elder James Heskell has been a dedicated member, deacon, trustee, minister, and groundskeeper for over 40 years. God spoke to him in a dream and told him how to contribute to this great church. The dream has guided his actions and commitment to the church, donating Bibles, hymns, and most importantly, his time to this church, in which he loves dearly. Give it up for Elder James Heskell.
Amen. Amen. Great man of God. Amen.
Giving all praise to God and the Lord of my life, the head of, not the head of this church, but the head of, I'm just happy to be here. This is a surprise to me. I didn't know. I see all my kids back there today. But I always like to prepare before I get up and say something for the Lord. I like to prepare myself, because sometimes the Lord tells me at night while I'm asleep what to do, what to say, you know. So therefore, but I'm just happy to get this award from the church. First, I have got small awards, but I've been here 47 years and been preaching and teaching and I was one that God chose to rebuild a church after it was burnt down. And the Lord sent me to get the loan and everything to build this church right here once it was born. Once it was burnt. So, but now I have a little speech problem. So I had to step down. But I'm still here just about every Sunday. Amen. Still pay my tithes at this church right here. Amen. And I'll keep on paying them long as the Lord making the way for me. And He's been making the way. Amen. I don't want for nothing, because the Lord is still making a way for me. And I thank y'all. God bless.
Amen. Elder James Haskell, amen.
Ben Butler. Ben Butler has been a jewel of our church and community for over 4 decades. His unwavering dedication to the church is evident in the countless hours he has selflessly given, the financial sacrifices he has made, and the skills he has utilized to support our congregation. Whether it's fixing something or cleaning the church, Butler has been the personification of commitment and generosity. His love for the church knows no bounds, and his willingness to roll up his sleeves and do whatever work is needed has left a permanent mark on all of us.
Y'all see this here? Where your tithes and your offering are going forth, this man here, amen, is a part of laboring to build this, amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Prophet, I call him, amen. You got to say something.
Praise the Gave and all praises to God.
Yeah.
I don't like surprise. We'll talk about this later. I do accept this award. Thank all y'all for honoring me for this deal. But this is, faithfulness is a part of my life. Yeah. From day one, I used to, when I first moved out here, behind the old church, I would drop my family off every Sunday morning and go to the racetracks. One Sunday morning, I dropped them off, and my daughter said, "Well, why are you dropping us off at church and you don't go?" I backed up. I came in the church, and I heard Reverend Sergeant preaching. I've been here ever since. When the church burnt, you know, that was, it's like my own home was burning down. But when we built this one, I know all the ins and outs of this church from the underneath. Like I was under the stage until 8 o'clock of the night, trying to get all the wiring and stuff done. I left my phone under there. Had to call the technician to call the phone. After he came back, we got the phone. I couldn't get out of the building. I had left my keys under there. So it's just a great honor to receive this award. May God bless all of y'all.
Yes, sir. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Pastor H.L. Williams. Our late founder, Pastor H.L. Williams, founded and organized this blessed ministry and named it Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. He heard the word from God and built a team, and together they started this ministry right out of the homes of the McGinties before moving into their own building on Silver Hill. Our founder is no longer physically here with us, but his legacy and ministry he built upon a solid rock stands forever. There is so much life in the vision God gave this man many years ago, and the results from that is you being here today. Give it up for Pastor H.L. Williams.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank God for giving the vision to Pastor H.L. Williams for Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. So we definitely praise God for him and dare not honor him in this moment, because if it had not been for him hearing the voice of God, none of us would be a member of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. Amen? Amen. Amen.
Reverend Nathan Charles Sargent. Reverend Nathan Charles Sargent became an ordained minister under the leadership of Reverend C.P.H. Kies at the Macedonia Baptist Church in Lancaster, Texas in 1978. He then became the pastor of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church in October 1978 after the passing of Pastor H.L. Williams. He grew the church from its Silver Hill location to its current location on Bonneview Road. He has ordained countless ministers, married hundreds of couples, and dedicated hundreds of babies back to the Lord over his 45 years in the ministry. He has served in multiple roles with the Oak Cliff Baptist Ministers Union and the Peaceful Rest District Association, including president of them both, the D. Edwin Johnson Institute, and numerous of other organizations. If I could say it best, he's the pastor to pastors.
I don't know if you have ever heard it like this. You caught me. I never believed, I never really had something like this happen on a day like this. But I know how to say thank you. Amen. For if there's anyone that we've had to go through, and you had those brethren that came up, even those that's gone away, to be in the place that the Lord is going to bring the rest of us if we do our right thing. But I want you to know how appreciative I am that you would do these. So as this, never thought it would happen. Didn't think it was raining. Anybody was doing things like this, but I appreciate it. And I thank my wife for helping me. Amen. I thank her. And I ask you to just keep on keeping praying for me, because still a lot of things are going, the devil's trying to bring it down. But I know I'm going up because the Lord has told me so. Amen, amen. And again, I want to say thank you.
Amen. We want at the end today with our bishop, amen.
Amen. We have amen. One more. Praise the Lord, ladies and gentlemen.
Pastor Byron C. Hanspard Sr. Pastor Byron C. Hanspard Sr., shortly after finishing in the NFL, he returned to Dallas, Texas from Atlanta, Georgia, and became a member of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church in 2003. Hanspard served as Bishop N.C. Sargent's armor bearer, youth pastor, and assisted him wherever he could be a support to the ministry. 21 years later, he is now the new elected pastor, where his wife, Yolanda, of 26 years, serves as a minister and choir member, and their three sons, Byron Jr., Brian, and Bryson Hanspard, All are active members as well, serving in various auxiliaries and ministries. Give a round of applause for Pastor Byron C. Hanspard Sr.
Praise the Lord.
Listen, y'all know I'm not, listen. This was supposed to be for all the honorees. I'm just Byron. I'm not trying to do that. But I appreciate you all recognizing me. Hey, First Lady told me I need to get used to it. But, you know, I love to honor people, amen, that's worthy of honor. I love to see smiles on people's faces. I love to see them excited and loving themselves, amen, and loving God. So that's just something God placed on my heart. And I just wanted to honor those that are worthy of honor. And like I said, it's not it now. I'm going to do some more research. I'm going to talk to some more patriarchs. Now that prophet and elder have been presented their awards, I'll be speaking with them, amen, for the other patriarchs that we're going to honor during church anniversary, the fourth Sunday of April, amen. And Mother's Day and Father's Day. So I want to say thank you to all of the families, amen, of our honorees that came with us to join with us today in this honor, as well as our Men's Day. We praise God for you. We do not neglect knowing that you came from your churches to be with us. So we want to say thank you, amen. We praise God for you. Thank you for sharing your loved ones with us, amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. I'm back. All right. Y'all want to hear another song from the male choir? But nah, we not going to do it. We not going to do it. Our contract is two songs. Hey, we're going to do a special presentation. I mean, Ralph Garrett is going to do a special presentation for us. You know, it's other ways to praise God. Amen. Amen. All right, then.
Recognize myself in the mirror. Who I am and who I see is no longer clear. Time has seemed to slip away, and what I thought was so close feels no longer near. But honestly, I know that I'm wrong. Though I feel weak, something is strong inside of me. So I'm not gonna quit, 'cause I know I've got something inside. And though I fail, I've gotta keep trying. Yes, I'm scared, but I won't let fear win, 'cause I hear this voice deep inside telling me that it's not a lie. Yes, I am, and yes, I can, and I will. They said that I could, they always doubt. Closed doors and rejection, I'm constantly fighting. It's like they want me to throw in the towel. Too many opinions, hate that I asked. How could they know what's been put inside me? They call me crazy, they can't figure me out. But honestly, I know that they're wrong. Something
hear a voice deep inside telling me no, it's not a lie. Yeah, I am. Yeah, I can. And I will. Is it you? It must have been you. The voice is you, Lord, telling me not to quit. Oh my God, it's been you. The whole time it's been you. Thank you, Jesus, it's been you. You've been pushing me not to quit. Inside, and though I fell, I gotta keep trying through the tears. Yeah, I might be scared, but I won't let fear win, 'cause I hear your voice inside telling me no, it's not a lie. Yeah, I am. Yes, I can, and I will, Lord, I will, I will.
Amen. Have y'all had a good time today? All right then. All right. Now I just want to put this one little thing in there. For the men's, you know, we're doing our special offering. So we trying each man, we want everybody to, you know, come over $300 when we do it for the men's. All right. Now if you don't have it, give what you got. But if you do have it, you got till next Sunday to get it in. All right, I got mine's in, thank God. And that's about it. Let me see, now we're finna do, Byron is gonna introduce the speaker, and that'll be all my duties, so y'all won't see me anymore. So, woo, I made it through. Thank God.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Y'all give a great big God bless you to Brother Early Wesley. Amen. Thank God. Listen, thank God for Deacon Early Wesley Sr. Amen. Who is the president of our men's. Amen. He's our president. So we thank God for the program that he has put together. It's been an awesome program today. Come on now, y'all can give it up. Deacon Early Wesley, amen. He's done a phenomenal job with the program, amen. Thank God for each and every one of you that are here. So with that being said, Deacon Early Wesley asked Byron Courtney Hanspard Jr. to speak. I didn't even know, amen. So this has something to do with Deacon Early Miller, my oldest child, amen, in whom I'm well pleased,
Amen. God has truly indeed anointed him and has truly indeed blessed him with a powerful word that comes from the Lord. Amen. So his mother, amen, Lady Hanspard, has done a phenomenal job with him. Amen. I was just a disciplinarian. She, all that there, all that talking and all that acting and all that standing, that comes from his mother. Amen. Praise the Lord. I know y'all say it come from you too, but yeah. He can talk like I can. Amen. So he has a time limit. Amen. Just want y'all to know he has a time limit. And if he exceeds his time limit, I will pull his coattail. Amen. Amen. None other than Minister Byron Hanspard Jr. Amen. Coming forward. Hallelujah.
Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise in this building. That'll be all right if that was for me. I said, come on and give the Lord a hand clap of praise in this building. Did he wake you up this morning? Did he start you on your way? Did he put food on the table? Did he put clothes on your back? So if I was you, then I'd give the Lord a hand clap of praise in this place. Because it could have been you outside with no shoes, with no clothes, left out alone without a friend. But you just got to hand you and just say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. I don't want to prolong the hour because we had a beautiful program that was designed. Thank you, Deacon Wesley, for always thinking about me, always for considering me for times and moments like this, giving unto God who is the head of my life, to Pastor-elect, my father, Pastor Hanspard, to First Lady, my mother, love you both. To Bishop and First Lady, thank you all so much for all that you do and for allowing me this opportunity. To you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, I understand and realize this is Men's Annual Day, amen? And there's a whole lot of men in the building. But I would be remiss if I didn't let everybody know that this one right here in the front row, she going home with me. So I give honor and praises to my wife, Mrs. Incredible. Go ahead and stand up, baby. Now. I don't need any misconceptions now. Try Jesus, not me. Amen. Amen. Please stand with your word in your hand. Father God, thank you, Father. We're so grateful for this time. We're so grateful for this opportunity, God, that we have to share in your word. Father God, I ask that you hide me behind the cross, God, and allow the power of your salvation, the authority of your resurrection, the strength of your name to fall fresh on this place, God. Father God, throw your weight around, God. Convict us in our hearts, God. Justify us in our minds, God, and allow us to continue to grow closer to you, God, because you are Lord and Lord above all creations. And we will continue to give you all of the glory, all of the honor, and certainly all of the praise. For it is in the mighty, precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen. If you have your Bibles, please turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 16. We'll start at verse 13. First Corinthians chapter 16, verse 13. It's in the New Testament. So that means you need to go to the back. And if you don't know your books of the Bible, read the table of contents. It's at the front for you. Amen. If you have it, say amen. Amen. If you don't, say wait. Wait. Hold on. First Corinthians chapter 16. Verse 13. And it reads on this wise: be alert, stand firm in the faith, be courageous, be strong, do everything in love. You may be seated. The word of the Lord is blessed. If I could use as a subject topic today, since it is Men's Annual Day, I would like to come from the subject Boys to Men, a pathway to promise. Now, ladies, I'm not trying to single you all out, but I'm kind of talking to the men today. But I will allow you all to eavesdrop and be a little bit nosy. And I don't think the men would mind. So understand, the author of the new gospel in 1 Corinthians was written by the Apostle Paul. Now understand, there is a backstory of Apostle Paul. He was not Paul to begin with. Before he became Paul, his name was Saul. And Saul was from Tarsus. And he was the one that was an eager Jew that went around persecuting Christians. And he had the mindset of destroying the church. As Paul was on the road to Damascus on the journey, he had an encounterment with God. And the light came down and it flashed all around Saul. And the Lord asked Saul, "Why do you persecute me?" And Saul was astonished and he asked the question, "Who are you, Lord?" And then Jesus replied, "I am Jesus who you are persecuting." Then the Lord commanded Saul to get up and go into the city, and he will be assigned what to do there. So understand that Paul wrote this book, and he was writing it to the church of Corinth to admonish them to turn away from their previous wisdoms, to turn away from their previous human knowledge and lifestyle, and to turn to God, which is the author and the finisher of our faith. So understand and realize the church of Corinth were functioning in paganism, which means to be worshiping several gods. So the polytheism they were functioning in had them living a double standard life. So Paul came and he writ the books of 1 Corinthians, and if there is a 1 Corinthians, there is a 2 Corinthians. And he addressed the concerns of the immorality that was practicing in the church. Immorality such as sexual immoralities, greedy, idolatry, verbal abuse, drunkenness, and swindler. And this is so that the people should repent and turn away from the things and convert to the disciplines of Christ our Lord, standing on the firm foundation. Understand the conversion of Saul to Paul, the deliverance as Paul went into the land that God had instructed him to go into. Understand, people were already there in great question. People were already there in great concern. How are you going to come in here and try to teach us what to do and you were just persecuting Christians? How are you going to come in here and try to tell us the way to live and you were just trying to slander the name of the Lord? And one thing that I realize and understand this is that the church of Corinth had to convert from going to a sinful living and turn it to repentance and total restoration. And I can just hear people right now, how in the world can Paul have the background that he has? How in the world can Paul have the dilemmas that he's had? How in the world can he have the history that he's been through? And now you're trying to teach us the righteous way. Am I talking to anybody in here that you've been in a position where folk tried to hold your flaws over your head? You've been in a position where people have tried to condemn you for the things that you've done. You've been in a position where people have tried to strip you of restoration and have tried to set a plan to pin you in the corner, that people cannot get a grip off of what was holding you down. But you need to tell them, hey, I was flawed up. I've been busting and disgusting. I've been jacked up, but he called me up. I've been twisted around. I might have been torn down a long time ago, but the Lord called me up. So in this moment, the Lord decided that he wanted to call Paul, and he used him in such a mighty way. And understand, the Lord had a divine plan for Paul. But this is what I want to leave you with right here. Understand this. We must be careful of the people who try to bring you back to the place that the Lord has already brought you out of. When God has set you free, understand that no one can hinder the plan that the Lord has for you. No one can try to take you back to bondage or captivity because the Lord has brought you out of it. So understand this. For whom the Son has set free, he is truly free indeed. Understand this. Be free in your mind. Be free in your spirit. Be free from depression. Be free from baby daddy drama. Be free from baby mama drama. Be free from low self to free. Be free in this place. Through further investigation, I feel good in this place. Through further investigation, this is Black History Month, so understand this. Boys to Men was an R&B group. And I know I have some old folks in here. I love me some R&B music. I got to be honest. I got that from my pop Lynn and from my pops. But understand, Boys to Men was not Boys to Men at first. Their name was first Unique Attraction. I got some folks in here that know what I'm talking about. And understand this, that group was formed in 1988. And the R&B group, New Edition, all right, they came out with one of their top songs that said Boys to Men. And that name there inspired the change of Unique Affirmations, and then they changed from Boys to Men. Pressing forward, Boys to Men had some top songs. Y'all stay in the spirit now. It was The End of the Road, I'll Make Love to You, On Bended Knees, Doing Just Fine, The Water Run Dry. But the song from Boys to Men, they expounded and they said something like this. From New Edition, it said, keep growing. Keep learning. Wisdom helps us understand. We're maturing without knowing. These are the things that change boys to men. Booker T. Washington gave an extraordinary, prolific quote that says, success is to be measured not so much by the position that one has reached in life as to by the obstacles which he has overcome while trying to succeed. Understand this, a false masculine doctrine teaches us that men are judged as being men based off on three categories. And the categories that I found is that three, that men are judged based off of their pocketbook, men are judged based off of the playing field, and men are judged based off of the bedroom. Understand and realize the pocketbook. If I don't make a certain money in my pocket, are you really a man? If I don't make plays on the football field, if I don't make plays on the court, are you really a man? If I don't know how to do the do, are you really a man? But understand this, I have some good news. What does God say about kingdom men? We understand what the world says. We understand the stigmatism that the world has. But what does God say about men? God says, my Bible says in Psalms 37 and 23, that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, meaning that I have to commit to the Lord and his lordship. I have to be governed by the word and to be ordered by my steps. And then he comes back along and he says, to delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Don't delight yourself in Jerry Springer. Don't delight yourself in Mari. Don't delight yourself in all of these different things out here, because understand that is a false doctrine. But when we align ourselves with the word of God, when we delight ourselves in his word, when we allow the Lord to be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, we have to walk upright before God because he changes our hearts. And understand, when I get to thinking about this verse, I think some of us get twisted up and discombobulated in our minds because we think, Lord, if I align with you, then you're going to give me what I want. But understand when he says, delight yourself in me, not delight yourself in BJ, not delight yourself in all these other things, but delight yourself in me. Because when you delight yourself in me, you begin to fill yourself up with my word. When you delight yourself in me, then you begin to talk the way that I talk. So when he says to delight yourself, and I will give you the desires of your heart, as the Lord mends our broken hearts and ministers to our minds, then we then be filled up with the power of the Holy Spirit. So then our ways are aligned to his ways. The way that we walk is aligned to the way that God has for us to walk. Because understand this, God has asked us to take our eyes off of our wills and our agenda and align ourselves to his will and his way. Can I submit something to you? Being the man is not always about the things that we can possess if your heart is not pure before the Lord. Understand and realize this. The word teaches us and it tells us, blessed are the pure in heart, that they may see God. Now understand and realize this. The way that we walk, the way that we talk, I have been made through the spirit of the word. We talk about justification and realize and understand with justification. Justification is the declaration of faith that allows the righteousness of God to be seen. Now understand, I think sometimes we try to dwell on passive righteousness. And what passive righteousness is, man, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z, and then I'll get in the gate. I'm going to act like this. I'm going to present myself like this, and then I'll be able to get into the gate. But understand, the Lord has done his part. The Lord has done everything for us that we need. So we don't think we need to bring a burnt offering to the altar. We don't think we need to try to live a certain way of the status quo of the world, and that'll get us in the gate. All we have to do is accept what our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, has done on our behalf. Because understand, this was not a worked inheritance. This was an inheritance that was given freely from our Father. So when we know and when we understand that blessed are the pure in heart, that they may see God, understand that I have accepted what God has done. I have accepted the declaration of faith that allows me to live righteous in the sight of God. Now let me remind you, because I know we get it twisted sometimes. Just because I am a child of God and I have accepted what God has done does not mean that this walk we live is a cakewalk. I don't know who said that if you turn your life over to God that you're going to have money like no other, that you're not going to have any problems, that it's not going to be any concerns, that it's not going to be any issues. But the Lord had already said in this life there will be trouble. But then he gives us a reminder that says, but you shall overcome the world. Now, I'm talking to the children of God right now. Because if you are connected to God, then you have the blood of God living inside of you. So when he said you can overcome, understand, we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. So anytime we're getting in our minds and thinking that, oh, man, if I just turn my life over to God, all of my problems are gone, I ask you to pick up this word and keep reading it. But understand and realize this, and it might only be a few people that might be able to agree with me on this, but understand that even when God called me out of darkness, right, into his marvelous light, I still ran away from God. Maybe it's just me, so I'm just going to talk to myself. I knew what the Lord was saying, but I kept aborting the mission. I knew what the Lord was calling me to do, but I kept putting it to the side, trying to do my own will, trying to do my own way, trying to walk with swag, trying to walk in the way that culture and society wanted me to walk in. But understand this, that through that walking, all right, I cannot stand firm, bold, and courageous like the Lord has allowed me to. And understand this, condemnation, regret, disappointment, and backlash are the things that fills up in our hearts and our minds when we try to walk on the barriers of life that have shaken our position. But in the act of being firm, in the act of being courageous, folk think that you're supposed to have it all together. Write that vote. Folk think that at the snap of a finger, every deal is settled, every thought is clear, every vision is battle-tested. Folk think it's happy-go-lucky when you try to swallow your pride and push through. Folk think they got one up on you just because you chose meekness over slapping the Negro out. Folk ain't got no idea how you've kept it all together when everything seemed to be shaking under your feet. Folk ain't got no idea that you've been functioning while being shattered. Folk ain't got no idea how you had to go through the battle without, they ain't got no idea have you had the means to do for somebody else, but you barely had the means to do for yourself. They ain't got no idea that you tried to talk to somebody who was committed to misunderstanding you. They got no idea. But understand this, they didn't realize that it wasn't because that I was strong. They didn't realize it wasn't because I could handle precarious situation. It wasn't because I wasn't educated enough to figure it out. It wasn't because I was cute enough to cover it up. It wasn't because I was strong enough to lift it up. It wasn't because I was rich enough to pay it up. But it is unto him who is able to keep me from falling. Do I have any witnesses to know that it was him? It wasn't my mama. It wasn't my daddy. It wasn't my baby mama. It wasn't any of those things. It was you. Though I've slipped, Father, though I've lost my mind, though I've stumbled, though I've almost lost it all, Father God, you kept me from falling. You kept me from losing my mind. You kept me from living in insanity. You kept me from losing it all. You kept me, Father. And if there's anybody in here, and I'll make two, that could just take a moment to thank God for keeping you in this place. Because if it wasn't for his goodness, if it wasn't for his kindness, if it wasn't for his mercy, I guarantee you we wouldn't be here today. So let's just take a moment and thank God for what he's doing, for what he's already done, and for what he's about to do in our lives. Y'all sit down. Y'all cutting up today. Y'all sit down.
Let me free you. The reason why he kept you from falling is because you tried to stand on your own will and it didn't work. You've tried to stand on your own understanding and it didn't work. You've tried to stand on your own wisdom and knowledge, but it didn't work. But understand this, you went back and you tried it again and you committed to the Lord. You denied yourself, you took on your cross and you followed him. And then understand this, now you're standing on his will. So I got news for you. In order to be in his will, I have to be on his will. And if I'm not on the will of God, I can never be aligned to the will of God. We listen to other philosophies but the word of God. And understand, when we listen to those philosophies, our feet are in quicksand. When we listen to those philosophies, we feel like that we should walk around on eggshells. When we listen to those philosophies, it detours us away from the solid rock, which is the word of God. Now, I have to tell you, you have to stand firm in the faith. What is faith? Our pastor has been doing a phenomenal job of telling us what faith is. Faith is the total reliance on Jesus Christ, our Lord. So understand and realize this. The anointing that God has placed on my life, it will fuel the destiny that God has for me. Which means this. If you're not fueling me, then you're distracting me from what God has for me. And my distractions have to be fueled to the place that God has for me to go. So understand this. My circle... catch this. My circle is either encouraging growth or it's demoting progress. Talking here, BJ Hanspard. My circle is either encouraging growth or it is demoting progress. Which means, baby boy, baby girl, if you trying to kick it and do all that other crazy stuff and it aligns to the word of God, yo, you got to kick it and we got to be gone. Because in this day and age, I don't know about what you got going on, but what I got going on, I got to live for God. I got to live for his righteousness. I got to walk in the spirit and not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So either you encouraging my growth or you demoting my progress. But the anointing that God has on my life, I can't sit here and twiddle and dabble with you and play the game. I can't sit here and associate with you but not think we ain't gonna have some type of powerful relationship. I just can't do it. Because the anointing that God has on my life, I have to be careful of the people that I connect with. So I gotta understand that my circle is either encouraging growth or it's demoting my progress. And realize this, the assignment that God has on my life, the assignment that God has given me, I can make it through any challenge that might come my way. But understand, a great assignment causes for a greater connection with the giver of life. And if I'm not connected to the giver of life, there is no way in the world that I can hear what the Lord is telling me. There is no way in the world that I can walk the way that he's telling me to walk. Why? Because I'm not connected to his word. And the Bible declares and it tells us that my sheep know my voice. But the only way that our sheep are able to know his voice, I got to plug into the word of God. I got to be connected to the word of God. I have to trust the word of God. I have to rely on my faith, which is the uncompromising word of God. As I close, my father told me I have a few time. I'm not going to keep you now. I married an amazing, beautiful woman. We got a chance to go off to Mexico, and we had a very good time. We stayed there for almost a week. She set it up. I just paid for it. Amen. So we went there. It was time to come back home. And our flight had been delayed. It had been delayed one, two times, I think. So we had to stay overnight. So I said, you know, baby, hey, I'ma go get our bags. You stay right here in line. So I come back and Harmony, she's upset. She's furious. So I'm like, baby, what's going on? Now, I can't cut up in the airport, so just tell me what's going on so we can either talk this out or you can just drop it and we can be done. So she telling me about a dude that disrespected her, that said something because she was standing in the line. So I said, baby, you know what? We good. We gonna get in line. We gonna keep doing our thing. I'm not gonna let that distract us from having a good time. So we take our bags and we go get in the line. So as we get in line, the very first person in front of us is the man that disrespected her. Now, the way that she walked, she said, yeah, there he go. Right there, it was him. He disrespected me. He said X, Y, and Z. Now, the way she did it was, she did it to where Buddy probably heard what she said, but now that she went and got her husband, he had a different type of movement. He really wasn't about that action because it was a woman, but now you got a man here with you now. And the way my father raised me, it's smoke in the city. Again, I said at the beginning, try Jesus, not me. And if you know the rest of it, then you know the rest of it. But my means of understanding this is understand that when she came with me, she had a different kind of approach. She was ready to go. She was flamboyant. She was ready to be about the business. But when she was by herself, she was a little quiet. She was a little reserved. But understand, in this walk with Christ, we got to do this. Stop leaving the Lord behind and bring him with you. Stop trying to act and function without the word of God. Stop trying to act and function without your father. Stop trying to make decisions without consulting your father, because with your father you can do everything, but apart from him you can do nothing. So I don't know who's in this place, and I'm taking my seat, that if you've done anything without God, try Jesus. If you tried anything without him, try Jesus. If you've connected with all these other things and they didn't work, connect back to the source. Fill up to the power source and allow the Lord to minister to your heart. Allow the Lord to minister to your mind, body, and your spirit, because with him then we have strength. Through him we live, we move, and we have our being. So when she decided to come up with her husband, she had a different kind of approach. Why? Because my husband is with me now. My strength is with me now. My armor is with me now. I dare you to take off your clothes and put his clothes on. The helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the sword of the spirit, and use the word of the God to fight through your troubles, to fight through your circumstance. Because understand this, in this life we will go through troubles. We already know that. But through it all, we can overcome by the word of the Lamb and by the words of our testimony. So if you're in this place right now, and if you think you can do it all by yourself, turn away from that thing. Connect back to God. I have to deny myself. I have to follow him. There's somebody in this place that you've been battling with identity. You've been battling with low self-esteem. You've been battling with depression. And you've connected to all of these other different things, and it still won't take. You're trying to take your charger and you're trying to plug it up all over the place instead of connecting to the word of God. If you hear me in this place, deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow him. Because the Father's not waiting for you to have it all figured out. He's not waiting for you to have it all figured together. If you tried to wait until you had it all figured together, then he died for no reason. If you tried to come to him when you had it figured out, then he shed his precious blood for no reason at all. Take up your cross and follow him. Because through him is where we have the fullness of life. Through him is where we have eternal life. And I don't know about you, but when this life is over, I want to hear him say, well done. I don't care about what they have to say. I don't care about what she thought. I don't care about what he thought. I don't care how he acted towards you. I don't care how she acted towards you. When it's all said and done, you want to hear him say, well done. Deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow him. Standing all over the building. Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, God, every hand lifted, every head bowed. Father, we honor you in this place. We give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. Father God, strip us from unrighteousness, God. Strip us from sinful living, God. Strip us from allowing us to think that we can do it on our own, that we can act on our own. But Father God, allow us to plug in and connect back to the solid foundation, which is the word of God. Father God, I pray a special blessing on each and every man that is in this place, God. Father God, remind him, God, that as he connects to you, God, that he is a kingdom man. It doesn't matter what she said. It doesn't matter what he thought. It doesn't matter what tried to come against him. Father God, if he connects to you, God, He will have the fullness of life. Father God, stop allowing us to try to figure it out by ourselves. Stop allowing us to try to pin the tail on the donkey. But Father God, allow us to run to you, God, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, God. Blot out all of our iniquities, God, creating us a clean heart, God, and renew a right spirit within us, God. We turn away from substance abuse, God. We turn away from sexual immoralities, God, and we run back to you, God, because you're there with your arms wide open, God. So, Father God, cleanse our hearts, God. Cleanse our bodies, cleanse our spirit, God, so we can be made more like you, God, so you can fill us up with the power of your Holy Spirit, God, with the power of your resurrection, God, and with the renewal mind of knowing, God, that we function through you, that we have our way of living through you. So if we've gone astray, God, if we've fallen down, if we've slipped, God, pick us back up again, God, and show us the way to do it the right way. And we will continue to give you glory, honor, and praise, for it is in the mighty precious name of Jesus Christ our Lord we pray. Amen. Come on and give the Lord a hand clap of praise in this place. I mean, if you truly love him, come on and bless and holy his righteous name.
And agree, because you're not going to continue to allow stress, doubt, frustration, unbelief to overtake your heart and overtake your mind. And you may just want to touch and agree and pray, because you're at the brink to where you feel like, I'm getting ready to give up and throw in the towel, but you've made it to the house of the Lord today. And because you've made it to the house of the Lord today, today, that you are ready to deny yourself, pick up your cross, and follow Jesus. If that's you, meet me in this middle aisle. We're going to pray with you, and we're going to pray for you, because the devil is a liar. You will no longer be defeated. You will no longer be cast down, but you will stand strong. You will stand powerful. You will stand anointed in the will of God. Hallelujah. From this day forward.
worship you. I'll give you glory. I'll give you praise. For you deserve it, Lord. For you deserve it, Lord. I'll give you glory. Because I am free. Because I am bold. And I will tell everyone I know. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The devil is a lie. He's not going to keep anybody under the sound of my voice bound again. You're not going to continue to be depressed or stressed or worried. The devil is a lie. Whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Amen. Ain't no turning back. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. For those that are watching, that are streaming, there may be somebody that's not saved. Amen. We may have some people in the house that's not saved. And I dare not leave without leading you into the repentance prayer, because at the end of the day, you have to repent. I tell people it's good to ask for forgiveness, but all you're doing is saying, I'm sorry. But when you repent, you turn away from that thing that is keeping you bound. You turn away from that thing that is keeping you hostage, and you go in the opposite direction toward the Lord. Amen. So we want repentance, not just forgiveness. Yes, Jesus died so that we can be forgiven for every last one of our sins. But there are some people that need to repent. Amen. So there may be some people that need to be saved. Repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I'm sorry. Forgive me. I have done wrong. I believe that you died and that you rose to save me. Blot out all of my iniquity. Create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for filling me with your Holy Spirit so that I can walk right, talk right, live right, and be right. From this day forth, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. If you prayed that prayer, amen, and you have not been baptized, amen, we want to make certain that you are baptized, amen, because we want you to be baptized with the Spirit. The Bible says Spirit and water, amen. We want you to be baptized. Now, there may be somebody that wants to be a member, amen, of the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. Before we leave today and before we go to presentations and do an offering, I want to open up the doors of the church, amen, because we may have somebody that wants to be a member, amen, of the great this church on this side of heaven. Amen. Hallelujah. We are progressing and we're growing and we're moving in the direction of God. Amen. We will continue to move in the direction of God. Is there anybody? 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 Amen. Praise the Lord. Deacon Wesley, amen. We're going to turn it over to Deacon Wesley before we go into our offering. Amen. We'd have one more presentation. Amen. Hallelujah. So we want to give Deacon Wesley opportunity for that presentation. Prepare your gifts, amen, as he comes. Amen. All
right. Didn't I tell you? Didn't I tell you? I told you we were going to have a good time in the Lord. Now, you'll believe me now, right? Now, you'll believe me. Whatever I tell you now, you'll believe me. But we had a good time today. You know, I feel like shining. You know, y'all just don't know. I feel like shining. Thank you. Thank you. That was the word. Now we have a presentation. Now, first, our secretary. We got the best secretary in the United States. Boy. I bring some junk to her, she straighten it out. She make it look good. So, first presentation to Shana Young. Come on down. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Next we have, y'all know, yeah, right here. BJ. Give a hand for BJ. Man. This guy preached. Thank you so much. Next we have Ralph Gary. One of them. Now this, he can keep up with a song.
Thank you so much. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Now, we're down to the big one. I mean, he is one of the best men that we have here at Faithful Missionary Baptist Church. And he do a lot of work around this church. He goes up and he prays, and he make people, just feel good because of the prayer that he put out. So he's talking to God. And that's none other than Deacon Kenneth Young. This is our man of the year. Man of the year. I gotta tell you a little something about it. I don't be on Facebook too much, but every once in a while I get on and look at blanks, you know, just prowling through. And I look on there and he's out front blowing the young off. I said, is it church time today? I said, maybe I got up on a Monday or Tuesday one. Maybe it's not Sunday, but he's out there blowing the yard off on the front. He comes up, he prays, and he put a phenomenal prayer. You got to feel when he start praying. You got to feel it. So Deacon Young, man of the year. And I've done something a little special this time. Since he's the deacon, the chairman of the deacon board, I decided I'd go ahead and put all the deacons on a plaque. Is that faithful, dedicated to the works of God, the 2024 Man of the Year Award presented to Deacon Kenneth Young in gratitude, appreciation of Christian dedication given this 25th day of February 2024. Faithful Missionary Baptist Church, Byron Hanspard, Pastor. Hey, I don't want you to drop it. I don't want you to drop it and tear it up, so put it back in the box.
Amen. Man worthy of honor. Amen. Deacon Ken Young. Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank God for Deacon Young. Amen. He has done phenomenal work here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church, and we appreciate him and thank God for him. Amen. It's offering time. Amen. I want you all to know that your tithe and your offerings are going. Amen. As you can see, we're doing renovations to the house of the Lord. Amen. This will not be it. Amen. So we appreciate your charity. We appreciate your gifts of love. Amen. We thank God that you're doing it in a cheerful way. Being cheerful givers, amen, not grudgingly, amen, but you're giving from your hearts, and we definitely appreciate God for you as you give, amen, as you praise God in your giving, amen. We have a, oh,
Okay, never mind. We have Givelify, amen, that you are able to connect with Faithful Missionary Baptist Church on Givelify, where you can also give of your tithing, your offering, your gifts of love. We have the Men's Day, amen. Men, you know, we know our responsibility today for Men's Day. We want to make certain that we fulfill our responsibility as well, amen. Ladies, you all can join with us, amen. Praise the Lord. We know next month is your day. Amen. But you can still be a blessing. Amen. Because it's all going to the work of the Lord. Amen. Praise ye the Lord. Amen. Amen. As you give, amen, let's not forget that this Saturday, March the 2nd, I believe, we will be celebrating the life of Sister Linda White here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church at 11 o'clock. Amen. Sister Linda White, we will have her homegoing service here at the Faithful Missionary Baptist Church at 11 a.m. on this coming Saturday. Amen. Amen. Continue to keep her family in prayer.
Just want to praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Counts to blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to you.
Today we definitely appreciate you. Thank you for celebrating our Men's Day today. We've had a phenomenal God time. Amen. Thank you for your presence. Father God, we thank you for what our ears have heard, what our hearts have felt. Thank you for the power of your Holy Spirit being present in the house today. Cover us with your blood. Protect us. Keep us safe from all hurt, harm, and danger. Allow your angels to be encamped around us everywhere we go. Everywhere we may be, everything we do and say, allow it to be pleasing in your sight. Bless the offering that has been given. Let it be used for the purpose in which it was given. We thank you that they've been a cheerful giver, God, and we expect you to bless us in ways we can't even imagine. We bless you, praise you, thank you, for it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. I'd love to hug your neck and shake your hand. Meet me at the door. Thank you.